It's important to dress right. I want to look slick, to look sleek, to look like a fresh thing. I've got a message. Well, actually, I am the message.
What are the issues for which you would kill? I like to ask my students this on their first day of class. I assign novels where the hero or heroine kills or is killed. I try to bring it home. They tell me they'd kill to defend their families. They'd kill to defend their friends. I ask them if they would kill for their country, for their freedom. What would it take?
Oh, I'd kill for a pair of Prada velvet platforms in deep plum. Those are to die for.
Simone, I didn't know what she was doing in my class. Neither did she, apparently. Nice segue, Simone.
Thank you.
Would we be willing to die for the same things we'd kill for? She usually sat in the back, rarely spoke, wore too much lipstick and some costume out of, what, Vogue? When she did speak, it was always disruptive.
I'd take a bullet for my daddy, but he's already dead. I'd die of boredom if it were lethal, but clearly it's not.
If I couldn't inspire her, I wanted her gone. I'd asked her to come to my office. I asked her several times. She was failing, obviously. I would have let her drop the class, but it was too late for that. She never bothered to come see me. Not until the day before the final exam. She wanted me to give her a passing grade. How can I do that, Simone? You haven't even read the material. Have you read any of the material?
I don't find it relevant.
How do you know if you haven't read it? You might find yourself surprised. Anna Karenina is wonderful.
It's long.
Why not give it a shot?
The books you assign are depressing. I don't want to be depressed. Why read something that's going to bring you down? Kafka, Jesus Christ. I started it, okay? The guy was just fucked up.
So you were moved at least.
Moved to shut the book and find something more interesting to do.
Haven't you ever read anything that's really moved you?
Nothing moves me, Dr. Ruth.
I'm going to have to ask you to put that cigarette away.
Okay. Ask. See art or be art. I choose the latter.
Someone must be paying for this education of yours.
How do you know I'm not paying for it?
I don't believe someone who is spending their own money would waste it so flagrantly.
Okay, Dad chips in.
Is this the same father you said was dead?
That was a joke or a lie. Take your pick.
You're frustrating the hell out of me, Simone.
Do you enjoy being a teacher?
Yes, I do.
So then I'm paying for your enjoyment.
It's not a sin to enjoy one's work, Simone.
I just don't think you should charge me if it's more for your pleasure than
mine. I didn't say that.
Did you ever want to teach at a real school? Not some second-rate institution like this?
I like my job. You're not going to convince me otherwise.
$4,298.
That is?
Dollars. It's a lot of money, right? Do you think you're worth it? I mean, that's like food for a starving family in a fifth world country for a year at least. It's a car. A used one anyways. It's a couple of Armani suits at best. I don't even like Armani. So hey, come on, can't you at least say, yes, Simone, I am worth two Armani suits. I have that to offer you.
The money doesn't go into my pocket.
Well, I think it should. It would be more direct that way, and you would feel more of a responsibility to me personally. I mean, don't you think so, Dr. Ruth?
I prefer you not call me that.
Wrong kind of doctor. Man, all you're interested in is a bunch of books written over 100 years ago, and the books written about those books. You're probably writing a book that was written about a book that was written about a book. Am I right?
You know, if you can't see the connection between books and life, you're not reading very well. I want you to try. Can you do that? Books might even show you a way to live.
I'm already living, Dr. Ruth, are you? I mean, it looks to me like you haven't changed your hairstyle in over 25 years.
You weren't even born then, Simone.
Aw, stuck in your best year? I imagine you in a short-cropped, spiky thing.
Oh, that's enough.
P.S. You might want to do something about the way you dress, love, Simone.
Have you been in therapy?
Don't think that's an original suggestion.
I'm not suggesting anything. I simply want to point out that this is not therapy. I am a teacher, not your therapist. You can't just waltz into my office and say whatever hateful thing you please.
I don't know how to waltz.
I give up here, Simone. You don't like my class. You don't like me. You want to fail out. I can't stop you. What?
Drew Barrymore would move me.
Who's Drew Barrymore?
Damn!
You really should know these things. She's extremely famous. She's been famous like ever since she was born. I saw her on TV yesterday and she was so real. She connected. You know, you really might relate better to your students if you got a little more up to date.
You might be right. And you might not be so behind in class if you spent a little less time watching television.
Drew is a film star. She's in films.
You said you saw her on television.
Damn, do you even go to the movies anymore? Probably only the ones that are totally L7.
And you don't even know what that means. Square.
They have these daytime talk shows nowadays.
I've heard of them.
And this chick was in the audience, and she started to cry. Because she couldn't believe she was in the same room as Drew, who's been famous forever, right? She was just sitting there, sobbing. And this chick, she had her bleached blonde hair, and it was pasted down real flat, and she was wearing a rhinestone barrette. Just like Drew used to, but the whole look, it's so old Drew, so 10 minutes ago Drew. The new Drew is sleek and sophisticated and coiffed. And this chick who wanted to be Drew so bad, she wasn't even current.
I don't think we're getting anywhere.
And that is so sad. Because the thing about Drew is she's always changing. It's a constant thing for her, the change, and that is like what you have to do. Keep moving or you die. Drew knows that. Drew knows that, how to invent yourself again and again so you can keep being someone you like, the someone you want to be, and then once you're it, you've got to move on. Now, where was it you were hoping we'd get to?
The exam is tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. If you read the material, any of the material, I might be able to give you a passing grade. But right now, I don't think we need to waste any more of each other's time.
You might have said that I go to the movies the way you read books. I would have mentioned that, Dr. Ruth.
Well, I suppose we don't think very much alike.
A wall between our souls? Look,
I'm sorry if I've been rude, okay? I'm sure a lot of people like your class. Maybe I wasn't raised well. I'm sure someone's to blame.
I live in worlds made by words. Worlds where the dead can speak and conversations can be replayed and held over and over until they are bent into new possibilities.
Do you think I'm worth it? Am I?